first taste of boxing was going down Barrow Amateur, watching my older brother. He boxed at an early age, 12, 13, maybe 14, I think he went up to then. Used to go sit and watch him train. I think he had four fights, and then eventually Mara watched him, and then he left, and then I joined a couple of years later, and then I ended up picking it up from there. Just went down for fitness at first, and ended up boxing.
What was your first thoughts when you walked in that gym, smelt the leather and saw them hitting the bags, and you know, did you think I'm in a good place, I want to be here, or did, you know, what was your...
I was scared. I was scared. I was looking around, seeing people pound the bags and that, and then I was just like, I liked it. It was a weird feeling because I liked it and I liked watching it, but I thought to myself, I don't think I could do this, but I did enjoy sitting and watching there as a kid and that, but yeah.
Well, come on, by the end of the day, Ross's desire to be a pro, and was having a great relationship with his old coach, Jeff. They're looking somewhere to go. They knew he was stepping up to the pro mark, and Ross decides to make, you know, the trip down to come and see us.
When did it click then? When, after them few hard sessions sparring, when did you think I'm going to take this seriously?
Well, what happened was two of my mates were boxing. And I'd gone back down just to do a bit of fitness with them, and I ended up starting to spar with one of my mates who was actually, had had 10 amateur fights and he was quite good. So I started sparring with him, and then eventually we started having good spars. So then my coach said, do you fancy fighting? And I ended up having my first fight not long after. In the amateurs, I had 57 or 56 amateurs finished off with. I boxed Spain, Denmark, Belfast, junior novice national champion, under 10s, senior elite semi-finalist at the age of 18, Northwest belt holder. It was just towards the end, I started getting a little bit disheartened with it, and I felt like I needed a new lease of life, sort of, and here I am now, starting with Steve and Sean and Jimmy Evans as a pro.
Well, at the end of the day, he's committed to us, so that helps for the start. He's got heart, he can punch, he's very busy, technically he's good, and there's things we're going to add to him, and we can make him a lot better, I think, I mean, with time, and obviously training in the day is going to help as well. He's going to be fitter. And his star will come on, you know what I mean? It's going to be exciting to watch.
Well, did you always know you wanted to be a pro boxer?
Not always, no. I didn't always know I wanted to be a pro. Just putting in 10 years as an amateur, it gets to the point where I'm thinking, what's my next step? And one of my good friends is doing well as a pro, and he sort of gave me the drive to think to myself, why not give it a go myself? And yeah, that's why. But moving on to how I got with Steve and Sean and Jimmy Egan's, a place came up to go over to Spain with them last summer, and they ended up picking me to go with them, and I won out there for them. And then my coach, amateur coach Jeff's, always had a good relationship with Steve and Sean and Jimmy Egan's, so it's just gone from there. Communication between us all, and we've all worked together, and now this is the position I'm in.
And what do you know about this gym and Steve and Sean, and you know, the history behind this gym and what you're coming into?
Well, I've always seen from the amateurs what type of fighters they produce, and they're always top fighters like you see on the amateur circuit. And I know they've produced since obviously the late Jimmy Egan, I know they've produced 25 national champions, and the latest one, Courtney McCarthy, the first female champion that they've had, so that's brilliant. Kofi, Hosea Burton, Macaulay, McGowan, Jimmy Kelly, Tyson Fury,
What is significant as well, having said all that, is that you're the first professional boxer underneath Sean and Steve as well to turn pro under this new regime that they're having, so you know, that's a good moment as well, and a special thing for you to set you on as the first pro. What do you think about that?
It is, it's a big moment. I'm very proud. I'm very proud of it. I really am. It's a compliment to me, and I'm happy to be working, more than happy to be working with Steve and Sean and all the lads in here.
all the Jimmys, you know what I mean, because it's our first actual pro, me and Sean and everybody, all the other coaches and the lads, they're well up for it, because it'll be the first one from here, and hopefully the rest will follow.
It's going to be tough, and the training's obviously got to be upped, and going to have to be fitter, more on the ball, obviously every aspect, weight, got to keep on weight and stuff like that, you don't want to go too heavy. Looking forward to it, yeah.
What are your ambitions in boxing?
Ambitions, take each fight as it comes and hopefully win each fight, and then you never know, do you? You just got to go from there. I'm not going to start saying I'm going to be this and I'm going to be that and I'm going to beat him and I'm not going to beat him or all that, but I'll take each fight as it comes, and I'm sure under the guidance of Steve, Sean, at Jimmy Egan's, I'm sure I'm confident I'll do all right, quietly confident, not going to start talking the big talk and that, but yeah.
Well, as you know, Chris, you know we've turned out plenty of champions, you know what I mean? And I don't know, it's not all about champions, but good boxers, you know what I mean? Fit, game, you know what I mean? Good style. And not everyone the same, you know what I mean? We turn out all sorts of fighters, aren't we, from this gym? I'd say to our national champs, we've had about 8 or 9 pros that have gone pro from here. And obviously world top contenders and world champions as well. And British title, and it's about time we had it with us involved, you know what I mean? Instead of other people getting the benefits of our years and years we've put into the lads, we want to feel the benefit too. And it's not financially, it's just good to get my dad out there, his name, on the next level, you know what I mean? So, it's me and Sean and the rest of the lads, but it's about my dad still, and it always will be.
I'm making my pro debut on the 24th of March at Bowlers. I'm expecting a good night, win, and good atmosphere from the fans, bringing quite a few down from my hometown. I think I'll sell a few tickets as well through the lads here at the gym. But yeah, no, I'm expecting a good night. It'll be a good night for everyone that night.
And anyone who's not seen your style or how you box, how would you explain your style?
Bit of everything. I can fight when I need a fight, and I can box when I need a box. And Steve and Sean are bringing the best out of me in terms of that. They're adding little bits here and there. So the more we work with together, I'm only going to get better. But yeah, like I say, I can do a bit of everything, I think. Yeah.
Exciting. You know what I mean? It's an exciting fight. It's not boring. You know what I mean? And watch his space, because I think he's going places.